trust, and do we have any options? Is there any alternatives out there to the one that could promise to give us an eternity in paradise? And there isn't. But into your hands I commit my spirit, because what else is there? It's the only hope I have, or any of us, and it's free insurance, so why not buy it? Because the fear of the Lord, reverence, deep and profound respect for God, and saying, wow, this is my rightful owner. I've got to try to share his mind and try to be more like him. I'm not going to lose my individuality. We're all going to always be forever more individual. I mean, if every snowflake is, for God's sake, every one of us is. But, you know, we've got to be humble and filled with humility and forgiveness. We've got to forgive ourselves. We forgive others if we're going to ever forgive ourselves. Even if their transgressions are worse than ours, it doesn't matter. Okay, it's at the end of the day, we've got to hold the olive branch out there to the bitter end with even the most vile of men. We can't condemn them. We must love them from our heart. We don't have to like them. We don't have to want to hang out with them. But we do have to hold that out there and just to tell them under no uncertain terms, this is the time written about, where you're going down through the power of God, through the power of knowledge. This is God working on earth through human beings. Knowledge. So the return of Christ can be a gradual thing. But it's coming. And we need to prepare ourselves. Look, we could get off each and every form of money gradually. And the evil men know it. If we had any semblance of true capitalism, which involves supply and demand, we would be pretty much off money by now in history, okay? You understand? Then that evil men know that. And to them, that's like this. Don't you? That they get less relevance. No, they want more and more, and they've gotten more. They've gotten their way my whole life. They keep debasing the money. This is how they do it. They keep increasing the national debt. This is how they do it. They enslave people. They normalize slavery. And this is how they've done it, through stealth. Long, gradual decline in the standard of living. Where was the Federal Labor Department protecting the standard of living promised to the federal minimum wage worker? That would have kept this country cohesive. Look what they've done now. Cities have to set their own minimum wage. Is this sick? This is sick. You think it's by accident? Either incompetence or evil genius? Yes, the latter, evil genius. Bad actors, I'm telling you, mean people, run the show. Look, the reason that they rule over the righteous is because they're willing to do things we aren't. Simple as that. They're willing to forego, to subdue their conscience. Normal people that gravitate toward their godly side, their conscience, and thinking there might be a soul and a God that I should be, you know, tread lightly with, you know, we have our boundaries self-imposed, thank God. They don't. They'll murder. Would you murder? Would you commit genocide? Would you start a war where innocent men, women, and children are maimed and killed? Would you do that? That's what they would do. So you wonder why they have an advantage. Well, obviously, inside of God, they don't, because you're not going to be able to inherit the earth. It's going to be the meek and the righteous that get the earth. Those that understand, I want God's will to be established on earth. And if God says, no, each and every form of money must go, then we must want what he wants, share his mind, and understand why. It can't. It's just, you look what it's done. Look at the misery that's caused by this crap. We all love it for practical reasons. God knows that. But we also have to understand it's got to go, man. But we could get off it gradually. Money should increase in worth because it gets easier and easier and easier to produce and supply all the things we demand and want. That's a simple empirical reason why your money's supposed to go up in worth, not down. And you think evil men don't know that? And that eventually, you can see the end from the beginning, you end up with universal prosperity. Zero, big fat goose egg, wealth imbalance. You think the evil men want that? These are top money lovers, you know, the money sign, right? They even put that on the typewriter, your keyboard. Satan, man. Satanic symbol, right? I mean, I don't know that to be true, but hey, it makes sense. I'm telling you, friends, this is how he rules. This is how evil men keep ruling over the righteous men. You know, thank God the law enforcement aren't like these damn politicians. And our service members are not either. No, a lot of these people, their eyes are open. They know that there's some bad actors at the uppermost echelons of power. And they know that's the cause because they're smart. And they know that that's on a local level in the community, that, you know, the violence and the crime, the thefts, all this crap. Even they did a study up in Redding in Shasta County here some time ago on the poverty level, how it was a lot of depression and desperate poverty up there. And people just, there was no jobs and there was none to hold down, and it just, this lingering poverty, and it was contributing, they thought, largely to the rate of rapes in the area, you know, which I was surprised me, but I'm telling you, man, money induces the vast majority of crime. Okay, end of story. So you think law enforcement doesn't know that? A lot of these people, they're not, I mean, you know, we all can understand why you want problems if your job is related to solving the problem. It's like, take a gardener, for instance, a landscaper, whatever. And you say, well, you know, the weeds are pesky, but if it wasn't for the weeds, and then me having to come and pull them because the person hiring me doesn't want to pull them or isn't able to, then I'm valuable, I'm relevant, I'm important, and I'm rewarded for that, right? I got to pull them. But if there was no weeds, my job security goes down. So we can all understand why, you know, the why and wherefore some people, if they're corrupt in law enforcement, they say, we got to keep crime because our jobs are involved here, our job security, our relevance. And you can see that in throughout the judicial system if you're being uber cynical. But I'm not that cynical, okay? I know the bad actors at the very top that are causing the problem. I know that our problems could be solved slowly and gradually over time with just the increase in the worth of your money. It's that simple. Crime rate would plummet. I'm telling you, it's sick. It really hurts me. It really pains me in a visceral way when I think about how we're being controlled by evil men. They just screw everything up. They're big fat flies in the ointment, big fat turds in the punch bowl of humanity's joy. And isn't it hard enough that we got this thing we call death hanging over our heads day in and day out? The Apostle Paul, he referred to the human existence like a mist. Here today, gone to Maui, you know. It's sick. It's sick that we got to contend with these freaking monsters that conjure up, that concoct, that create these problems artificially from whole cloth. It's just, they're monsters. I mean, they really are working behind the scenes and in a way that, well, you can't see us, but we're right in your face. It's like, you'll never figure out the game. Yeah, we not only think we're smarter than you, but they're so delusional, they actually believe. So they project that. I'm smarter than you. I'm smarter than you. Are they? Are they smarter than you? They're not smarter than me, friends. I know how the game works, and I know why they rule over us, because they're willing to be violent. I'm not. I say, we're at chapter 12, Daniel. Knowledge is key. God is giving you and I and everybody else the knowledge at this point in history only. So you understand and you're empowered to fight these freaking monsters and tell them what's what and expose the living crap out of them in every way we can. And tell them, look, God's will is going to be established on earth. You better run and hide, just like it's written and predicted in Scripture. They're going to ask the mountains to cover them. And then you start learning about all these underground cities that are already built. And you think about hell and Hades and the separation that God promises. It's like, you're not going to keep God between a rock and a hard spot forever. At some point, he's drawing the line in the sand. He say, you beat up on my saints and the righteous and meek, my children out there, and I'm done with you. Get away from them. Stop bullying my children. It's that point in history we're at. You understand? when God's going to get his way and it's going to be forced and it's going to be traumatic for a lot of people. And they're, oh, God's a big meanie. He's forcing his will. What have they been doing the whole time through violence? God's not using violence. He's using knowledge and exposing these monsters and giving us the power of the knowledge to stand up with confidence and proclaim, gigs up, dudes, jigs up, whatever. You're going down. So get ready. I'm sorry, but you've been mean and you got to go hang out together. You're not fit to be around people. And remember, it could just be one of them, but we know it's more than one evil man. But a critical mass doesn't have to be anything near a majority. So the majority of humanity could very well be righteous, but off track. And so bought in too much to this delusion. And look at the monsters you're buying into by complying to this system. This current establishment, this trajectory we're on, this greater and greater wealth imbalance, and this is the cause of all the bloody revolutions in history. All the wars stem from this kind of crap, because evil men just don't know when to stop. They're like drunken, snot-nosed, spoiled brat children, and they demand someone to stop them, but they're demanding violence because they're willing to use that to keep getting their way when the chips are down and it hits the fan, but the righteous don't have that in their arsenal. They don't have that arrow in their quiver. So they've got to be, just tell them, look, I don't, you kill me, you know, you don't like it, but I'm going to keep being a squeaky wheel. I'm going to keep being something you don't want to hear. I'm not going to be music to your ears. I'm going to sting them as best I can with the power invested in me through God Almighty to tell people what's what. God's will is going to be established. God's children are going to be set free. That's the promise of Scripture. The captives must and will be eventually set free at the very hand of God, and human beings being used vicariously by God to stand up against the monsters and say, we're putting all our lives on the line. We're not going to use violence because we're going to win this time. You're going down. You got that? Yeah, another reason to be sad is the chemtrailing they've been doing for the last couple of decades. People think it's a conspiracy theory. Even Wikipedia is saying it's a conspiracy theory. No. You don't have to search far. This has been around, this technology to interfere with the weather, for many, over half a century. You understand? So don't tell me you're low. You don't. There's not that many planes flying. You see some days they're back and forth. If you're paying attention, but a lot of people have cognitive dissonance. They can't deal with it. So conspiracy theorists, no, you're nuts. That's just normal contrails. And yeah, they cloud up the sky. But what are you going to do? We need to fly. It's such a load. God, people are so stupid. It's depressing. You take a beautiful blue sky day that Mother Nature gave us, and we turn it to milky, ugly-looking crap. God knows what the effects are on the microorganisms, the ecosystem, on our health, on all the other health of the fauna. I mean, you know, and you're just going to put blinders on because I can't deal with it. I got bills to pay. All right, I'm on some recent current events and other talking points. I want to make a correction. Last week, I used the term worldly wise when a far more appropriate term would have been worldly minded. You know, it's an easy trap to fall into, you know, just to love your life in this world. And that's a trap, my friends. So if you're sorrowful, remember, you're sharing the mind of God. And he's, I believe, at his wit's end. And we got to start getting at our wit's end and just say, man, we need relief. And even if it's not affecting you personally and directly, you're getting your share of suffering through osmosis. You have a failsafe called a conscience, which is related to your soul. And, you know, God loves you too much to not discipline you and make you think about other people's unnecessary suffering at the hands of evil men through money. That's it. It's really very simple and sick. You wouldn't think it's that simple and they could get away with this crap. But think about it. No other creature on earth has any use for this crap we call money that we value so much for practical reasons. It's like, God Almighty, we're so screwed up as a species. Admit that. The original sin, there's the only explanation why we're this stupid and why evil men have been trampling over the righteous for millennia, thousands of years, since the inception of money. Evil men could not resist it, man. And they've hoarded it. And they've been, you know, there's a lineage of these people you can trace. It's sick and perverted, and it must go.